our today's module. In this today's module, we are going to learn about the payment securities and legal issues in India. So here we are going to see the various kind of payment security while doing the e-business or e-commerce. Okay. So our first topic is issues relating to the privacy and security in e-business. Privacy refers to the control over the use of individual personal data. Security is a protection of the individual data from the unauthorized access. Like anytime any information you put it on any website, it is relating to the someone, it is related to the someone's personal information. So here you give the particular kind of security to those kind of data. Okay. Privacy and security in e-commerce are extremely important as the internet is an open space and any information can be accessed by anyone on the internet without the knowledge of the person whom the information is belong to. So lots of miscommunication can be happen. So in this case, you need a privacy to be controlled on. Okay. So in this, e-commerce is concerned with the conduct of business over the internet, and majority of mandatory information shared by the parties on interest for the purpose of purchasing something on internet. Example here you can take about how you share your information like your email ID, name, phone number, address on your various shopping.coms like Amazon, Myntra, Jabong. So this is your private information, so there should be that kind of security and privacy over there. So there is a thin line between your security and the privacy. Privacy refers to the control over the use of individual information, and security is a protection of the individual data for e-businesses. Okay, there are some areas of security concern in e-commerce are as follows. First one is authentication. Since the parties in e-commerce transactions are not known to each other, authentication become extremely important. Like anyone can give any number, so authentication plays very important. Authentication is a process by which the parties identifies each other. It helps the acceleration and genuineness of the both the parties, and it helps the transaction to be more smooth. Authentication can be done by providing the exchange and return of and refund options by sending the test of the products. Next one is your integrity. Integrity refers to the consistency and accuracy of data when it's sent over the internet between the buyer and a seller. It refers to the information being received by the parties without any interruption or alteration. There could be an issue of if the message sent by the party is altered to someone else. Kisi ka message kisi ne alter karke bhej diya through the hacking, so it may be create a mess at the particular kind of stage. Okay, so integrity is more important. Non-repudiation. In the party to transactions denies the sending or receipt of an e-commerce message, the another party can be affected. Non-repudiation is ability to ensure that parties is to a transaction cannot deny communication sent by them. Okay, for the purpose, digital signature may be used with other measure to prevent the party's communication. Example, there are various sites where you need a digital signature. अगर आपका digital signature लगता है और आपने सामने वाले को बोला कि अगर मैं digital signature नहीं दे पा रहा हूँ, so in that particular case, there is a problem into your transaction. So this is a case you have to take into the consideration. A false claim of the receivers that message has not been received, this can be happen in this case. Confidentiality. Anything which you send over the internet, it has some kind of confidentiality. Confidential data refers to the protection of data from access by unauthorized users. हमारे पास बहुत सारे hackers होते हैं. There are many people who misuse the information. So इसलिए आपको सारी information जो होती है वो confidential रखनी पड़ती है. No one else should be able to access the information shared between them. In order to ensure the confidentiality, it is essential to use a proper encryption and description techniques while sending and receiving the message. मतलब आपका communication का जो process होता है, that used to be in a proper format. Right from the sender, encoding, decoding and receiver, this should be on the proper place. Okay. So this is the another point is your confidentiality. Next is about your privacy. Privacy refers to the ability of the customer to control the use of information provided by him to e-commerce website for the purpose of e-commerce transactions. It refers to the, you have to keep the data very private that somebody has given with some kind of trust, so you shouldn't misuse that. आजकल डेटा ट्रांसमिशन का बहुत फैक्ट चल रहा है, लाइक डेटा परचेस किया जाता है. यू रिसीव द मैसेज फ्रॉम एनीवन एंड यू ऑलवेज वंडर हाउ दिस पीपल गेट द मैसेज फ्रॉम गेट माय नंबर. सो दिस इज अ समथिंग व्हिच इज हैपन इन डेटा ट्रांसक्रिप्शन. सो इसके लिए प्राइवेसी प्लेज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. पर्सनल डेटा देयर फॉर कस्टमर्स आर सब्जेक्टेड टू रिस्क इंटरप्रेशन और आइडेंटिटी थ्रेफ्ट कैन बी हैपन. Customers are also consistently concerned about unauthorized access to their information because of the poor security. Bank ke bhi bahut sare cases hai that we many times we heard about that, like this happened, transactions happened, somebody has removed the money. So this all happens because lack of privacy. Availability refers to the ability of an e-commerce site to be available, the use of when expected by the customer. It refers to the availability of the information on the website when the customer wish to access it. So there should be the proper availability of the information should be there, like what is the payment policy, what is the payment policy, then what is about your do's and don'ts while making the payment. So these all things should be there into your e-commerce business. So these are certain issues which we face while conducting the e-business. Our second top point is common privacy and security issues in e-commerce. Very common things which are happened. First one is viruses. Like we have the various viruses, so we have the antivirus system for it. Virus attach themselves to download files and get access to the computer when the files are run on them. Virus cannot spread without human action, that is hacking. Hacking ke siva virus is not going to be entered into the site. Okay, virus can spread, can be sent through the spam documents we always have or spam mails which we have. So this is a format where you can get the things. Then it is about the steal information from the device. Delete certain files, even completely delete the content on the hard drive. This can be happened through the virus. Worms. Worms are different from the virus. They do not need any host to spread. They can replicate themselves through the internet and can affect millions of computers in hours. Okay. Worms overload themselves with the message and use up a system resource like system memory, network bandwidth, causing web servers, computers network. So this is a very dangerous than virus. Trojan horse is a descriptive program that look like a genuine applications. There are very much false applications which we go through every day. It enters into the system when the user get tricked into downloading the application. Anytime we get the message like don't download anything, just go through this, there are some fake news, there are some fake links which are coming, so don't open into that. So there you can get the this kind of Trojan horse. Okay. Steal the user's account data, browsing history, download all the things, whatever you are downloaded, everything is come into the scenario over here. Next is come to your spoofing. Spoofing attacks when it's a miscellaneous party interpreted another device and use a network in order to launch the attack against the network's host. Steal data, spread malware or bypass access control. So this is regarding that denial of service attack, that which is called as DOS attack. Denial of server attack inside the hamper the capacity of e-commerce server. The server, the customers over here share their information and they deliberately make the inaccessible or many other attempts should be failed where you can put up a lot of information about you. Okay, then it about the phishing. Phishing can be defined as the act of sending an email to the user falsely claiming to the established legitimate enterprise and in attempt to spam the users into surrounding private information that will be used for identity theft. Okay. Cyber validation. Cyber validation is an act of demanding someone's data using the computers. That disproves the victim's business image due to ending the data of making it something which is invalidable, something which is not usable. It is one form of your cyber crime which you are making it over here. Okay, so this is a method. Then adware. Adware refers to the any software that is designed that track the user's browsing habits based on the advertisement and pop-ups. Spyware. Spyware works similarly like adware, but it is a user computer without their knowledge authorization. अगर उसका knowledge नहीं रहेगा तो वो authorize नहीं कर पाएगा. Okay. Then credit card frauds, which is very much common nowadays. This is most common type of fraud happening on the internet. The hacker gains access to the credit card information of user using various codes, e-commerce websites, the user's information used to card online. Okay, so these are the various frauds which are happening.